This is the school. Well, that's what we call it anyway. The real school's just over there in Wilson Street. Moonee Pond Central, actually. A place of great learning, I'm sure. But its significance for us racing folk is that the eastern end of the building lines up exactly with the 600 metre peg here. And at the Valley, doesn't matter what race it is, the rule is you've got to be doing something at the school. You've got to get going here. You can't wait for the straight. And it was here in 1986 that Bonecrusher and our Waverley star raced away from the field to slug it out, blow for blow, like a couple of heavyweights. From here, from the school to the post, that's the way it was. Inelegant, rash, dead honest. The best two-horse war you've ever seen. The stuff of legends.
Our Waverley star and Bonecrusher have bounded up.
And this is how the connections of our Waverley star watched what once nearly was theirs.
Bonecrusher, they sprinted past the opposition. Grout moves up into third placing. He's two lengths away. Stewart's pulled the whip on Bonecrusher. Our Waverley star's going better than Bonecrusher near the turn. Stewart riding desperately on Bonecrusher. Our Waverley star leads him by about a length. They've cleared away from the opposition. Drought in third place. Racing, followed by Dinky Flyer and Drawn. Here's Bonecrusher raising another effort. The two New Zealanders turn for home with Bonecrusher, a narrow leader from our Waverley star. The Filbert battling on. Bonecrusher and our Waverley star stride for stride from the Filbert. This is worth coming miles to see. The Bonecrusher on the outside. They hit the line. Bonecrusher beat our Waverley star in one of the greatest races ever. Third placing to the Filbert. They were followed by Drought, then Dandy Andy, Dinky Flyer, Tristram Drawn, March of Keita, Everready, Society Bay, Romanat.
And number two is in the frame. The Big Red, and he's earned the title today. Number two, Bonecrusher, ridden by G.M. Stewart, is first. Number three, our Waverley star, L.O. Sullivan.
Our Waverley star will want to be far up. Here's Bonecrusher. He's pulling to the outside, shooting around them, and our Waverley star's going with it. Aberidi at the head of the others with Drought, Dinky Flyer, the Filbert and Tristram. Here come the New Zealanders, our Waverley star and Bonecrusher. They've raced to the lead, 600 out. Have they gone too early? Two lengths to Drought running up the third from Society Bay. They were followed then by Drawn under the whip at the head of the others, Dinky Flyer. But our Waverley star, he got a half length of Bonecrusher. He's gone for the whip on Bonecrusher. Three lengths to Drought, followed then by Dinky Flyer and Drawn. But the two great New Zealanders have come away on the turn. Our Waverley star, a half-length Bonecrusher. The Big Red won't give in. Drought running on. Bonecrusher responds to the whip. The roars of the crowd. He races up to our Waverley star. 100 out. Bonecrusher, our Waverley star. Stride for stride. Nothing in it. Our Waverley star, the rails. Bonecrusher the outside. And Bonecrusher races into equine immortality. $1.5 million as he photo finishes our Waverley star.
The crowd is roaring its head off. The judges call for the photo. Bonecrusher, ridden by G.M. Stewart, is first. Number three, our Waverley star, L.O. Sullivan, second. Number one, the Filbert, G. Murphy, was third.
Here's Gunsend hooked to the outside, followed then by Triton and Monufique, followed by the Fixer and Gay Icarus. Up by the 500, Torto in front, but the three-year-old Longfellow at his girth, and here's Gunsend three deep, about to tackle them, and Longfellow and Gunsend have swept to the lead near the turn. They're followed by All Shot Out, very wide, running on from
out, and Like a Lover, three lengths in front of Strike Again out after it. Arnelly's gone, coming into it again, Milfleurs, and here's Swell Time around the outside with Taj Rossi. They were followed by Zambari and Glengown, making a run and a long gap to All Shot. With 400 to go, Like a Lover's gone, Swell Time hit the front. And led by a length on the turn to Taj Rossi, tackling at Zambari, and here's Glengown out wide, putting in his claim.
They're six deep, Tara's Bulba trying to get a run in the centre, and they were followed then by Battle Heights on the outside, and Bellotta on the turn, Flash still in front.
Other side with 600 metres to go. It's Unaware, a half to Elton, a half to Purple Patch. One to Surround on the fence, a half Tara's Bulba, he's gone. How now commencing her run, and then perhaps followed behind those horses then on the inside by Northbridge Lad from Better Draw. Unaware Let Go has raced to the lead. Shivery's getting off the fence, but Dulcifer is going to have a big lead on it at the four.
This has now dropped out the last. Up the side, inside the 700 metres mark, they run. The leader was Ruby by a neck now to racing second. On the outside is Narilla. Miss Capital goes now to third about, four lengths to Bo's Desire. They're followed further back by Simona, Nebri and Star, and Valley of Roses, a bad last. On the final turn, short of 400 metres to go, the leader Ruby by three quarters of a length to Narilla. Then two and a half to three lengths to Miss Capital, running third, is now under extreme pressure.
And Towns cantering. We're going
to
see.
To go to the lead. He's had no luck, but he's charged to the lead. From Handsome Seattle, Perfect Bliss, Come to London's gone. Strawberry Road trying to get out of a pocket. Here's Sadapa hooked four or five wide with Mr. McGinty. Two to Trasaro, L.A. Bijou, Albany Bay. Emancipation's last on the corner. Fine offer and Handsome Seattle.
In the centre there, battling on is King Phoenix and Red Anchor, and the outside of them from Mr. Ironclad, King Delamere, and then further back, Labrici, Riverdale. But Street Cafe, Clements kicked it away a length and a half.
So you think by a neck to More Joy is zipping right there third, but under extreme pressure. Then Arvienis followed by Shooter.
Dangling one off the fence, followed by Iramu, Inralo, Kotari. And 4 metres away, Michael Manley. Around the turn, though, at the 250.
Start to make their run. The mare pulls to the outside, lets a lope around Siniston. Mannerism went back to the fence. Old Superimposed peeling to the outside with Betalution up. There's a fall. There's a fall in the Cox Plate. And Naturalism's lost the rider. Siniston is out of the race and so is Palace Rain. Rough Habit has been knocked out of it now. And as the race to the 500 metre mark now, and the leader here is King Jatay.
And Bill Collins got it so right, didn't he? When Bonecrusher raced into equine immortality. It was the day another legend was made here at Moonee Valley in a race that most described as the best they had ever seen. But that's the Cox Plate. Heroics define heroes. The Cox Plate creates a legend. Just got to be there.
Coloma Gem slow out, so was Wanelda, and also Wilray Lass back last of all. I'm settling down. Wanelda's back second last, in fact, was almost last, but this last now Wanelda. Around the second turn, and the leader was Solana by two to Coloma Gem, who's rolled right up along the inside now to be second. Traveling down the back of the leader, Savala by a half length, Coloma Gem, who's getting up along the inside. 5 lengths away, third, then came Gorilla Blue, there followed further back by Ice Flap, one other couldn't win. On the home turn, Savala drew 2 lengths in front of Coloma Gem, and Savala's going to be too good. Savala first and one by 2.5 lengths to Coloma Gem.
The man's headed for a different exit, the northern end. Leave Lacey to me.
Just a moment, madam. Please.
I'll see how Keith is. Trouble?
No, not me. Ask Lacey Nickers.
Desmond Lacey received 5 years imprisonment for conspiracy to steal, resisting arrest and assault on police. Stephen Rogers was sentenced to a total of 5 years on a number of convictions for larceny from a person. Angela Ward received a total of 2 years for her part in the same offences.